Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
Dear learners, this is a video for the subject of education for the course of Bachelor's in Education and for the paper of Child Development and Learning. This topic is under intelligence and this lecture is going to focus on the theory of multiple intelligences given by Howard Gardner. This video is recorded by Dr. Iram Khan. The course coordinator and the presenter or subject matter expert for this video is Dr. Iram Khan from Jamia Millia Islamia, New Delhi. And the academic expert or reviewer for this video is Professor Jaseem Ahmed from Jamia Millia Islamia, New Delhi. This video is produced under the project DTH Swayam Prabha Channels of MHRD, New Delhi. Hello dear learners, I am Dr. Iram Khan, Assistant Professor at IASC Faculty of Education, Jamia Millia Islamia. Today we are going to discuss one of the major topics from the theme of intelligence, which is the theory of multiple intelligences by Howard Gardner. So let us start the discussion. The objectives of this discussion are that we are going to define the multiple intelligences, various types of intelligences proposed by Professor Howard Gardner, then the attributes and features of the multiple intelligences and the educational implications of the theory of multiple intelligences. First of all, let us see that what exactly we mean by intelligence. So, intelligence has been defined in many different ways. It can be a very general mental capability that, among other things, involves the ability to reason, plan, solve problems, think abstractly, comprehend complex ideas, learn quickly, and learn from experiences. It is not merely bookish learning, a narrow academic skill, or test-taking smarts. Rather, it reflects a broader and deeper capability for comprehending our surroundings, catching on, making sense of different things, or figuring out what to do, what to have. So all these capabilities, if we combine all these things, we can say that we create a kind of phenomenon which can be told as intelligence. So now let us see what exactly this theory of multiple intelligence says. So a general perception of learning abilities of people is restricted to three basic categories. These are, the first category is visual learners, then the auditory learners, and the kinesthetic learners. But there are many theories and approaches towards human potential of learning through multiple ways. So we are right now making a premise to learn this theory of multiple intelligences. In order to do this, let's see that what exactly will be the first thing which we have to discuss about the theory of multiple intelligences. We have seen that the broad categories of general perception or learning abilities are the three of these which we have mentioned: the visual learners, the auditory learners, and the kinesthetic learners. So among these, the theory of multiple intelligences proposed by Dr. Howard Gardner, who is a professor of education at Harvard University, is having great importance. So in the year 1983, through his book Frames of Mind, The Theory of Multiple Intelligences, Gardner proposed this theory. Initially, Gardner reported seven types of intelligences as an outcome of his work in psychology and human cognition, and also human potential. So, but today, right now, we have a list of nine different intelligences with the possibility of even expansion of many more types in future. So, This theory is the focus of today's discussion. Whenever we are talking about the theory of multiple intelligences, this particular terminology or this particular thing which is called as human potential is the foremost thing which we have to discuss. So in this context, the human potential can be connected to a person's preferences to learning. Gardner has focused on human potentials, which comes out of the facts that every individual has a unique blend of intelligences and capabilities. Here, the intelligences can be regarded as skills. So these skills are developed by individuals for solving different type of problems. So this human potential was given a very kind of specific place in the theory of multiple intelligences by Howard Gardner. Now let us see what is this theory is all about, the theory of multiple intelligences. So this theory has emerged from the cognitive researches done by Professor Howard Gardner and makes the documentation of the extent to which individuals possess different kinds of mental abilities, and therefore they learn, they remember, perform and understand in different ways. So according to this theory, we are able to know the world through language, logical mathematical analysis, spatial representations, musical or rhythmic thinking, the use of body to solve problems or to make things, and understanding of other individuals, and through an understanding of ourselves, where individuals differ in is in the strength of these intelligences and so-called profile of intelligences. So we can say that in this way, in which such intelligences are invoked and combined to carry out different tasks or different problems, or solving different problems, and progress in various domains actually is dependent on the strength of all the combination of these intelligences. So this theory of multiple intelligences say that every individual is actually having a combination of all these different type of intelligences, and maybe there is a possibility that one of the types may have a more dominating role, more dominating place in the personality of a human being. Now, let us see what else Howard Gardner's multiple intelligences theory has to say. Basically, the multiple intelligences can also be regarded as different learning styles. So in the theory of multiple intelligences developed by Gardner, there is the provision of 9 different and independent domains of intelligence, which can be regarded as verbal linguistic, logical mathematical, spatial visual, bodily kinesthetic, musical rhythmic, interpersonal, intrapersonal, naturalist, and existential intelligences. He has a view that the individuals who fail in some of them may excel in others. So Gardner further mentioned that schools and educational institutions traditionally emphasize only linguistic and logical abilities, while neglecting different other forms of intelligence. So now we have to see that what exactly this learning style is all about. So let us see and discuss the different categories of intelligences or learning styles proposed by Gardner in detail. So the first one which is mentioned here is the verbal linguistic intelligence. What exactly this means? So the individuals having this learning style tend to use words very effectively. These learners have highly developed auditory skills and often think in words. They like reading, playing word games, making up poetry or stories. So they can be taught by encouraging them to say and see words, read books together. Tools including computers or different multimedia games or multimedia activities, books, tape recorders and different lectures can be can be a good tool for learning for these type of students or learners who have this type of particular learning style or the intelligence. So the best professions suited for these guys will be of copywriters, editors, historians, journalists, then lawyers, linguists, then poets, then even in public relations and media consultancy. They can be good speakers, teachers, trainers, can be good translators in the media industry for TV and radio presentations, voiceover artists. These people can do very good job. They can even be good writers. So this is the first one, which is verbal linguistic intelligence. Now let us see the next one, which is logical mathematical intelligence. So what exactly this logical mathematical intelligence mean? These individuals who have this type of intelligence have this learning style, which is tend to using reasoning and calculating very effectively. They think conceptually, abstractly, and are able to see and explore patterns and relationships in a very efficient manner. They like to experiment. They like to solve different puzzles, problems, and they ask different questions, which are very typical in nature. So this type of learning style or specific intelligence is covered under the logical mathematical intelligence. These people, they can be taught through different logical games, then investigations, mystery solving activities, and such type of different activities. So they need to learn and form concepts before they can deal with details. Otherwise, they can be confused. So this is also one of the limitation that first of all, they need to form the concept before they deal with the intricacies and the details of actually going ahead and learning the concept in a more rigorous manner. So the best profession suited for them will be of a statistician or an analyst, arbitrator or a banker, computer programmer, then accountant, maybe an engineer, insurance broker, researcher, or a scientist, and maybe a trader. So all these professions will best suit to a person who is having the learning style or a specific intelligence which is inclined more towards logical mathematical type. Now let us see the next type. So now let us see the next type, which is spatial visual intelligence. So the individuals having this learning style think in terms of physical space. It is found in the architects and sailors, or those who are driving the big ships and different convoys. So they are very much aware of the environment and like to draw, play with jigsaw puzzles, read maps, and use to be daydreamers. So the best way to teach them is through drawings, through verbal and physical imagery, and many more such type of activities. The best tools for teaching them are through the different photographs, charts, then graphics, the 3D modeling, videos, different models, drawings, multimedia, and textual material with pictures, graphs. So these people can be best if they follow a profession which can be in architecture. They can become good architects, artists, cartographers who make or draw the maps, then city planners, engineers, graphic designers, inventors, landscape architects, photographers, sculptors, and such type of professions where there is a need of looking more keenly towards the space, the relationship of space and the visual approach to see something. So this is spatial visual intelligence. Now let us see the next type. The next type is bodily kinesthetic intelligence. So the individuals coming in this category can use their body very effectively. They have keen sense of body awareness. They like movement, making things. They touch very properly. They touch things in a very meaningful way. So the dancers and surgeons are the best examples of having this type of learning style or this type of intelligence, the bodily kinesthetic type of intelligence. They communicate well through body language and be taught through physical activity, hands-on learning, acting methodology or role playing. So the best tools for teaching them include equipment and real objects. They can be given the equipment and real objects and they can be asked to make a practical attempt. So they will learn best through this. So they can be good anthropologists, athletes, biologists, dancers, geologists, instrumentalists, then health workers or nurses, physical education teachers, surgeons, physical therapists, then different physicians, actors, and even sign language interpreters. So this particular type is the bodily kinesthetic intelligence. Now let us see the next type. So this type is the musical rhythmic intelligence, or you can just call it as musical intelligence. So the individuals with dominating musical intelligence show sensitivity to rhythm and sound. They love music, but they are also sensitive towards sounds in their environments. They may study better with music in the background. So you must have seen few students who actually learn or solve different problems while listening to music. Few of us don't feel like that this is the best way, but for them, those who are following this method of having some music in the background, that is the best way of learning. So they can be actually best taught by turning lessons into lyrics, speaking rhythmically, and then tapping out time. So this speaking rhythmically is something which is difficult or typical for us, but this is something which is going to help these people who are having the musical type of learning style or the musical intelligence. So the best tool for them, for teaching them, include musical instruments or music, then the radio or stereo or any type of multimedia which is used for playing the music. So these people can be good acoustic engineers, then DJs or composers, entertainers, then noise analyst or environment analyst or music producers, musical instrument specialists, then singers, then musical performers, voice coaches. So these type of professions will best suit to them. Now let us see the next one, which is interpersonal intelligence. What exactly is this? The individuals with dominating interpersonal intelligence understand best through interacting with others. These students learn through interaction. They have many friends. They show empathy for others. They are street smart people. They can be taught through group activities, seminars, dialogues, etc. So the tools best used for teaching them include the audio conferencing or maybe discussion method, then the instructor led discussions or video conferencing, computer conferencing or emails or any type of writing which is actually can be useful for these type of learners. So for them, the best suited professions will be of advertising professionals, caregivers, coaches and mentors, counselors, educators, health providers, then human resource professionals, mediators, politicians, then psychologists, and sales executives, teachers, therapists, trainers, and many more, wherever there is the requirement of using the interpersonal skill, the human relations, and the relationship making or bonding activities. These guys, these people who are having this type of learning style or intelligence, they can excel. So this was the interpersonal intelligence. Now let us see the next. The next is the intrapersonal intelligence. What is this intrapersonal intelligence? We just see that who are these individuals. So the individuals with dominating intrapersonal intelligence tend to understand one's own interests or goal. They understand their own selves in a very proper manner. These learners tend to shy away from others. They are in tune with their inner feelings. They have good wisdom, intuition, and motivation. They are self-motivated people, as well as a very strong will. They are very confident people, and they have very kind of strong opinions. So they can be taught through independent study and introspection. Tools for teaching them include books, good books. They are very book loving people, creative materials, diaries, or privacy and time is the best tool. If you give them some time, that some private time, they automatically will strive here and there, and they are in a position to learn by themselves. So it will be right to say that they are the most independent of all the categories of the learners. So the person from this category is the one who is self-aware and involved in the process of changing personal thoughts, beliefs, and behavior in relation to their situation. They can adjust with other people very properly. So the eighth and the ninth category of intelligence are added by Professor Howard Gardner just few years ago, and they were not the part of these seven types of, which were actually given primarily, but afterwards, later on, the two types were added, and these are the naturalist and existential intelligence. So now let us see what exactly these two types are, these two categories mean. So this one, the eighth category, is the naturalist intelligence. The individuals with dominating naturalist intelligence have the ability to recognize and categorize plants, animals, and other objects in nature in a very proper manner. They are very sensitive people towards the nature. So individuals who are high in this type of intelligence are more in tune with nature and often interested in nurturing, exploring the environment, and learning about species. They are interested in subjects like botany, zoology, environmental science, then geography, biology, etc. So they can excel if they get some sort of profession which is related to environment, which is related to like working with plants, with close vicinity in with plants and animals. So this is naturalist intelligence, which is the added one, the eighth type of intelligence. Now let us see the next and the ninth one and the last one, which is proposed by Gardner. So the existential intelligence, what exactly is this? So according to Gardner, the individuals with dominating existential intelligence have the sensitivity and capacity to tackle deep questions about human existence, such as what is the meaning of life, why do we die, how did we get here in this world, and many more such type of questions. So they are very kind of philosophers, or they actually question the existence of human life and life on earth. So this was the ninth type of intelligence, and with this we have completed all the nine types. Let us see what else we have to see. So after the nine types of multiple intelligences, now let us see the various educational implications of the theory of multiple intelligences. So the first implication can be that the multiple intelligence theory can be used as a tool to achieve more success. Teachers are strongly motivated to help all students to learn. So therefore, they have explored multiple intelligences theory as a tool that makes more students to learn and succeed. So the great majority of the classrooms are characterized by the existence of scholastic winners and losers, or you can say that only the scholastic part of a student is explored inside a classroom. So the multiple intelligences theory is important here because it teaches us that all these students are smart and they differ only in the way in which they are smart or smarter. So in this way, we can say that all children have potential, and using multiple intelligences increase the opportunities for students to learn and succeed, which can give the adults more ways to grow professionally. Like once they become adults, they can grow in a better way, in a more professional way, and they can become a better citizen or a better person if they explore their different multiple intelligences and their own potentials. So this is the first implication, which says that if we understand multiple intelligences or this theory, and we actually make it our strength, then we can achieve more success in our life. The next one is that multiple intelligences makes learning more enjoyable. Students learn better if they like what they are learning and if they are enjoying what they are learning. So this is a proven fact. Basically, if you are teaching something which the students are not enjoying, they get bored and they tend to actually getting involved in all those activities which will annoy at times the teacher. So it is hard for students to learn without any interest. So when students do not like what they are learning, they feel bored and they become tired. Even if they are able to learn well and succeed in their final exams, then also that particular learning process is not interesting to them. So therefore, it is better to create an enjoyable classroom atmosphere in which students like what they learn and they enjoy. So this enjoyment, this happiness is actually very much important in a classroom. So using a multiple intelligences theory in the classroom can help the teachers to create such an encouraging and a joyful atmosphere. So it is evident that students learn best when they enjoy what they are doing. So giving them the opportunity to display their talents, learn new skills without the fear of embarrassment or the fear of failure, or maybe that they will be mocked, or there will be the other peer group is going to make a mockery of them. So if the teacher can maintain such type of environment where the child is not embarrassed to actually perform whatever he or she likes to do, then the teacher and the student relationship will also strengthen, and this child, the student, will also become very much keen towards showing or showcasing his or her talent in the classroom. And in this way, this learning process will become most enjoyable for this learner. So this can be in this way for making the classroom enjoyable. This multiple intelligences theory, the understanding of this theory will be very much helpful. Now, let us see that what exactly multiple intelligences theory acknowledges. Basically, multiple intelligences theory acknowledges individual differences in learning. We know that all the students are different. All the students have some good qualities. So no two persons in a siblings are exactly the same. Even in the identical twins, you will find that there are certain things which are different. So even the same person is different from one period to another, or from one situation to another, in different ways. So you can find a person when this person was staying at one place, he or she was showing different capabilities, and after a few years when he is displaced and has gone to some other place, and now this person is very much has gone involved in the activities at this different place. Even this person at two different times showcases different type of capabilities. So difference is the rule and stability is the exception. So this is applied to students while they are learning in their classrooms. So it is a fact of classroom life that what interests one student leaves another board. Literally two distractions, basically it can be a distraction for another student. So it is also a fact that the student who is the most enthusiastic on one day is often to become most bored on any other day. So this phenomenon can leave students feeling like not very much associated with whatever the teacher is actually teaching with. So at time it becomes frustrating, and the student feels guilty, or once the results are not very proper, then even this child feels very much guilt. So the theory of multiple intelligences not only helps to explain this phenomenon, but also helps the teachers to find ways around the obstacles to learn. So therefore, multiple intelligences is greatly required to deal with the different students who have different minds. It will involve all the students with their different personalities to have more chance for learning and achieving success in their differences. They have to accept that they are different, and then also this uniqueness is helpful for them for their future endeavors, and this is not going to hamper their future lives. So this was all about the different implications of the theory of Gardner. So Gardner quotes that these differences challenge an educational system that assumes that everyone can learn the same materials in the same way, and that a uniform, universal measure suffices to test students' learning. Indeed, as currently constituted, our educational system is heavily biased towards linguistic modes of instruction and assessment, and to a somewhat lesser degree towards logical quantitative models or modes as well. So practically, we need people who collectively are good at different things. A well-balanced world, a well-balanced organizations and teams are necessarily comprised of people possessing different mixtures of intelligences. So Gardner's multiple intelligences theory can be used for curriculum development, planning, instructions, then selection of course activities and related assessment strategies. So instruction, which is designed to help students develop their strengths, can also trigger their confidence to develop areas in which they are not as strong. So while doing this, students' multiple learning preferences can be addressed when instruction includes a range of meaningful and appropriate methods, activities, and assessments. So with this, we have come to an end of this particular session. Now let us summarize what today we have learned. So this topic on the theory of multiple intelligences, which challenges the notion of general intelligence. It defines intelligences as a set of abilities, talents, or mental skills that permit an individual to solve various types of problems. So we have discussed all the 9 types of intelligences which were proposed by Gardner and the educational implications of his theory. Gardner himself asserts that educators should not follow one specific theory or educational innovation when designing instruction. So instead, they should employ customized goals and values appropriate to their teaching and student needs. Addressing the multiple intelligences and potentials of students can help instructors to personalize their instruction and methods of assessment, which will be the best way to deal with the students' learning. So, in this way, now we have concluded this particular topic, and I hope that this discussion proves to be useful for you all, and we will see each other in a different lesson some other time. Thank you so much. Dear learners, you were watching a video from the major topic of intelligence, and this lecture was based on the theory of multiple intelligences given by Howard Gardner. I hope that the lecture was very much useful for you all. This video lecture was recorded by faculty at home during the national lockdown period for COVID-19 pandemic using minimal technical resources. Technical errors, if any, are unintentional and may please be ignored. For any queries with regard to this lecture or broadcast, kindly send your email to techsupport@dth.ac.in. Thank you so much.